What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I've just got a quick little video for you today. Got a trip coming up here in a few weeks, and one of the things you want to make sure you've got taken care of when you are taking trips for photography purposes is you got to back up your data. The last thing you want to do is like go on a cool trip, see awesome things, take all these wonderful pictures, and then get home and realize a card got corrupted or something got water damage or someone stole a bag, and then you lose all your photos. So the important thing here is redundancy. We're not gonna have quite the luxury of a full like 3-2-1 backup just because we're out and about. There's not gonna be good service, and uploading to offsite is gonna be not really feasible. Historically, I would use a couple Samsung, the T7, external hard drives, and every night we would get back to like the hotel room, dump cards using a laptop, and put a copy of the photos on each drive. Those drives have worked really well in the past, but I don't have quite enough capacity, so I'm gonna try something different this time. We're gonna run with these NVMe enclosures, as well as these 1 terabyte NVMe solid state drives. These will be a bit faster than the other drives and give me some upgradability. I can always put larger drives in these. These plus our other drives will give us 2 terabytes total of redundant backup, so we can then, well, keep our data safe. So let's go ahead and get these suckers installed. So first thing we're gonna do is, well, open up the packaging, because that's how that goes. Oh, that's cool. They give you a little screwdriver. Huh. I had my screwdrivers all ready to go. I don't even need those. We'll see if the screwdriver's any good. Did I just drop? That sounded a lot like the screw.
Yeah, it's under your chair.
Okay, well, we're gonna have to take off points for the singular little teeny important screw for this whole assembly just being loose. That's probably not a good thing. Okay, so it comes with a couple data cables. You get your USB-C and your USB-A versions. Okay, so take your screw out under your drive. These things are really, really simple. All they are is an interface to go from the, well, it's an M2 slot, but it's effectively a PCI Express slot. They've got screw adapter compatibility for a bunch of different sizes. So they come with a little thermal pad. I don't actually know if we need those or not, but just in case we do, we can use those. So for these, I just got, I don't even know what brand these are. SP, I think is the brand, but they had a 2-pack of these for like $67. So pretty good value. Honestly, it doesn't really matter what you get all that much for when you're doing these. Just get an enclosure and a drive. Double check the specs of each to make sure you get something that's like compatible and you don't end up with like a massively faster drive compared to your enclosure, just because you don't want to overspend on one and then waste it on a bottleneck from another. So these will go, they tuck into this slot like that. It's keyed, so it'll only go in one way. It'll take a little bit of pressure, you bend it down. They come with these little rubber bumper things. Those will fit onto the notch on the drive, and then just press in. That'll hold it in place. Okay, put your thermal pad on your drive, and then this comes in here. It just keys in and presses down, just like that. You find your little priceless screw that's floating around your table. You stick it in the hole, like you do, and tying it down. And that's pretty much all there is to the assembly. It's pretty straightforward. And now you have an entire terabyte of super fast SSD storage and something, I don't know, what's a good comparison for that? In one pocket knife worth of space. All right, so we got a computer and we got our drives. Let's go ahead and see what kind of setup we need to do. Plug it in, come into disk management, open that up. So it should pop up here that you have a disk that you need to initialize. You say okay. It'll think for a second here. And it'll show up here. You'll say new simple volume. Just pick the max size. We'll let it just assign it to what it wants. I think for compatibility, we actually want EXFAT. Make sure you tell it to do a quick format. Oops, I actually want to give it a direct name. So I'm gonna say it's NVMe 1. Like that. So it shows up here, 931 gigs. If we come to our file system, you'll see it here. And if you go in here, you should be able to see it here. You can tell it to eject it. And there you go. That's pretty much all there is to it. Do that to the other drive, and then when you're out and about on your trips, whenever you are done for the day, you dump all your cards off, put a copy of your photos on each drive, and then make sure you never store both of the drives in the same place. So if you're out and about, take one drive with you, leave one in the hotel room, or keep one on you, keep one in the car, keep one in the hotel room, or keep one in the car. Like, always keep them physically separate from each other. That way, if like you're having a car accident or someone steals your bag or breaks into your room, like, you're protected, like, you don't have both drives in the same space. But yeah, other than that, that's pretty much all there is to it. That's how you can keep your data safe while you're out and about, and hopefully you never have to deal with data loss, because it's not fun. So anyway, hope that was helpful. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments. I'll try and help you out. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the video, and we will see you on the next one. Bye.